My name is Tushar Rai, and today our topic will be suit for dissolution of partnership. I'll be covering why the dissolution of partnership takes place and what all points are to be drafted at the point of filing an application for suit for dissolution of a partnership. So first I'll introduce what dissolution of partnership means. The dissolution of a partnership firm takes place when the relationship between the partners of a firm is dissolved or terminated. We will discuss the primary way of dissolution, that is by the intervention of the court or otherwise, and further the steps involved in both the ways have to be briefly explained to facilitate the dissolution of the process of dissolution. So first we'll discuss the reasons of dissolution. In India, it is very often that the partners of a partnership firm have arguments or disputes among each other, which results in the dissolution of a partnership. The dissolution of a partnership firm is a process in which the relationship between partners of a firm is dissolved or terminated. If a relationship between all the partners of a firm is dissolved, then it is known as the dissolution of the firm. The dissolution of a partnership generally occurs when one of the partners ceases to be a partner in the firm or in some other firm. And other causes of dissolution are the bankruptcy or death of a partner, an agreement of all partners to dissolve, or an event that makes the partnership business illegal. A suit can be filed in the court for the dissolution of partnership of a firm to have a final decree. And in section 44, it is mentioned in the section 44 of the Partnership Act 1932, which provides a provision for the court of the provision to the court for the dissolution of a firm. So dissolution of a partnership firm may be affected in the following ways. First is dissolution without the intervention of the court, dissolution by the court, or dissolution by mutual agreement. And first is dissolution without the intervention of the court. So it can be done by an agreement, by compulsory dissolution, insolvency of partners, unlawful businesses, dissolution of the happening of contingent event, expiry of fixed period on achievement of a specific task, death of a partner, insolvency of a partner, resignation of partner, dissolution by notice. So these are all the reasons behind which a dissolution can be done without the intervention of a court. And in what ways a court can help in dissolution? First is the court may order for the dissolution on the basis of insanity of a partner, incapacity of a partner, misconduct by a partner, constant breach of the agreement by a partner, transfer of interest, continuous losses, just and equitable. And dissolution by mutual agreement. In the case of dissolution of firm by a mutual agreement, it is required to be followed that there has to be a dissolution deed in which the consent of all the partners has to be mentioned. An advertisement needs to be given in at least 2 local newspapers, and it should be published in a official gazette, and it would also be required to submit documents along with the NIL balance sheet to the registrar of the firm. So in the plaint, what all we have to mention is under the suit of dissolution of a partnership, these are the things that should be covered. First, the plaintiff and the defendant who are carrying a business in partnership under the name and style, their name should be there. The difference or whatever reasons that have been arising between the plaintiff and defendant, as it is not possible for them to carry on the business or a partnership anymore. Third, the plaintiff has to be requesting the defendant for the dissolution and to settle the accounts between them, and on to which the defendant does not pay any attention on the request of the plaintiff, and the plaintiff should always be entitled to dissolution of a firm and to such amount may be found due to on accounting, the cause of action and the suit arose with the date and day and the jurisdiction of the court in which the suit is applicable. So these are all the things, the most of the things which have to be mentioned in a suit for dissolution of partnership. And also we have to mention the value onto which the jurisdiction and the court fees which is to be paid. And under the prayer, we have to mention what the degree which should be passed against the defendant after the dissolution of the firm एंड इन केस इट इज फाउंड दैट द प्लेंटिफ इज एंटाइटल टू पे मोर अमाउंट दैन द डिग्री सो सच अमाउंट काइंडली बी पास्ड बाय द फॉलोइंग कोर्ट एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ द सूट एंड अदर रिलीफ शुड बी ग्रांटेड टू द प्रॉपर एंड granted to be deemed to be fit in this case with the verification and signature of the plaintiff and his advocate. So these are all the things that are should be mentioned in a suit for dissolution of partnership. Thank you.